Welcome to Learn Instrumentation Engineering. Dead band. We might have came across a typical technical word, dead band. It plays a major role in understanding measurement and control system in instrumentation. So we would detailly explain the concept of dead band in this video. So in this YouTube channel, Learn Instrumentation Engineering, you would be learning basic concepts and fundamentals of instrumentation and control system, technological updates and upgrades which is happening globally in instrumentation engineering, and we would also cover latest oil and gas news in our channel. So if you are a budding instrument student or a beginner instrument engineer or even an expertise in the field of instrumentation, do subscribe to our channel to learn instrumentation engineering, and I am pretty sure I add more values to your knowledge. So let's get into this video. People talk dead band majorly in pressure switches applications in process industries. The dead band is also called as switch differential action or differential limit. First, let's see what is basically a dead band. Let's see the definition of a dead band. A dead band is a region of pressure where a change in pressure produces no change in measurement output or control signal. Don't confuse. If you don't understand this definition, let me explain you with an example. Before that, let's see how does a pressure switch work. So in your pressure switch, you set pressure is 10 bar. In normal condition, pressure switch is in NO contact, that is basically a normally open contact. When the process pressure would increase and achieve 10 bar pressure, the pressure switch will actuate by changing the contact to normally closed contact, NC contact. This contact would either provide an output signal as an alarm or trip or any other control as per the process requirement. This is how your pressure switch work. So when the set pressure is achieved, the contact changeovers. By this way, it provides an output signal to control the process parameter. So this is a basic function of a pressure switch. Okay, where does this dead band comes into the picture? Yeah, I could understand your question. Let's see this picture. The x-axis is time and y-axis is pressure. We have a set pressure of 10 bar in the y-axis. So when the process pressure gradually increases, it reaches the 10 bar pressure. During the gradual increment of pressure, the pressure switch doesn't sense any pressure and it remains in its original contact, NO contact, normally open contact. When the process pressure achieved 10 bar pressure, the pressure switch changes its contact to NC, that is normally closed contact, and by this way it gave an output signal to the process requirement to control the pressure. So now something happened in the process. So the pressure starts to decrease. So when the pressure would decrease, now you could see over here, the pressure gradually decreases, and at some point of time, the pressure switch contact remains in same contact, that is NC contact, normally closed contact, until some point of time, and then the pressure switch contact change over to its normal condition, that is normally open contact. You could see over here, this is the actuation pressure and this is the reset pressure for this pressure switch. And it is very clear that from this point to this point, there is no actuation of the pressure switch, though the pressure reduced. Though the pressure set point is below the 10 bar, there is no output action, and this is called a dead band. So you could see over here, the dead band got raised at 9.8 watt. So we could clearly tell that the dead band for this particular process switch, for this range, is 0.2 watt. So this is basically the dead band concept. So let's get into the definition again. So dead band is a region of pressure where a change in pressure produces no change in measurement output or control signal. All switches have this differential action, that is the dead band action, because it is an inherent in any snap switch, right? The differential action or dead band cannot be eliminated. Normally, bored on tube and diaphragm switches typically have narrow dead band, while piston switches have broad dead band. So we have to choose wisely on this pressure switch depending upon the minimal dead band as per the process or requirement. So in this video, you would have understood what is basically a dead band with a clear example. If you like this video, just hit the like button and share to our instrumentation community. And if you want to watch such technical videos, do subscribe to our channel, Learn Instrumentation Engineering. Thank you.